I use OneNote every day. I use it for personal things. I use it for business things. I can keep it all in front of me at one time. And either if you use OneNote a little bit or a lot, usually think about it as my OneNote. It's on my computer. But the way that we're using computers now, the way that we're using devices, we have multiple devices. Maybe you have one or two at work, one at home, one at work. We have smartphones, all those things. That there's ways to share OneNote for the people that you want to share it with. And we're going to show you about that today in today's webinar. And the biggest beneficiary about this is you, because you can share OneNote yourself and get it on multiple devices. Let me show you what I'm talking about here. I'm going to click over to OneNote. And let me just do a little brief, real brief. We can talk about this at the bottom of the hour if you're on the live webinar about how OneNote works. But basically, OneNote, most people know, is a scrapbooking device. So you can take shots from the web, put them in OneNote. You can get them stamped with the time and the URL, so it's a reference for there. The setup here on the page, we will check. You can see that on the left-hand side of the page, I have notebooks. On the top of the page, there's tabs in each of those notebooks. And the right-hand side, there are pages in each tab. You can organize OneNote as well as one of my twin daughters, like her room is, or you can be messy like the other twin daughter I have, because you can search for anything very quickly in OneNote. So that's a great way to get around. And then for sharing, you can, again, you can keep OneNote on your computer and not do anything with it. But when you put things in the cloud using SkyDrive, SkyDrive is free for anyone. You get 7 gigabytes of storage. You can go there right now and sign up. If you have a Hotmail account, an Outlook.com account, an Xbox Live account, you already have an account there. You can get and use that storage immediately. You can store anything there, just not office documents. But when you put your notebooks onto SkyDrive, you can share them with multiple devices, including your smartphone. So this is going to be the little story of Doug and his bathroom. Don't worry, it's G-rated. What I did was I had a project that I worked on. We had a bathroom remodel. And what I did was I put this OneNote notebook on SkyDrive, so I was able to get it onto my phone. Now, I have a Windows phone here, and you get the best integration between Office and OneNote on a Windows phone because we make the Windows phone. But you can, the same scenario you could do on a PC, and if you had an Android phone, an iPhone, or an iPad even, you could do exactly what I'm about to do here on those devices, and we can show you those, we'll get those links to that. So here I have, you know, some drawings that was made about the bathroom, and then what I started doing here was just start going through and getting notes. So, you know, OneNote, you can put things anywhere. You don't have to worry about how organized they are. So square footage, places I wanted to go visit. You can see the blue links. Those are probably still even live. I could click to them and go to them if I want to, even though this is a year old. And then I took pictures with my smartphone here. And again, if you're on the live video feed, you probably can't see that. But I have the same note here on my OneNote on my Windows phone as I have here on my OneNote. And you can go through. So here I took pictures instead of writing down things about, you know, what this is or dimensions or prices. I just took pictures. And then here's a comparison I did. And yes, that's my actual hand. And just to show you how that works, here's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to show you how quickly this syncs. We're just going to take an actual picture here. So I'm going to insert picture. And I'm going to insert a live picture. And I'm going to take a picture of some of the happy people we have here. And, okay, except that Jean didn't know she was going to be a camera star today.
I don't think I was smiling.
Well, we'll see what happens now. So this will sync and take a minute or so. Just to show you some other things here that you could do. Here it's, again, I took pictures of prices for remnants that I may want to use for the flooring. By the way, the bathroom looks great, just so you know. And because of OneNote. And on the right-hand side, I just cut and pasted things from the web for certain faucets. So again, it's just this kind of scrapbook that you can keep online and also work with on your phone. Now let me go back and see if that page is synced up. Not yet. Okay. OneNote syncs in the background. There, you can press buttons to kind of start the syncing process, but it should just work. So I'll come back to that, and that will be online shortly. I'm convinced of it. And maybe later we'll video edit it in. But let me just show you some of the things here with notebooks and also some other sharing. So as you can see, I have several notebooks here on the left-hand side. personal, Doug's binder, how to webinar. Those are connected to different sources. I have a couple on my SkyDrive, my personal SkyDrive. I have some on SkyDrive Pro, which you get when you're in a business. We have other ones here. They're on SharePoint sites. And I've linked them up, and they all seamlessly just work together on one page. So I have everything I want right in front of me. So that's kind of one of the wonders of OneNote. And look, there's the picture. There you go. Look how beautiful our people are. And, of course, how beautiful the board, the meeting room are here. Lots of color. So again, that's how things sync up very quickly with OneNote. Now, a couple of the things for sharing. I've had a couple of notes of this, and people left comments about meetings. One of the things that people use a lot for OneNote is just keeping track of work things, meetings. So in the ribbon here, there's this meeting details. So you can pick a meeting that you're having. I'm just going to pick this one right here. And it will populate that page with the materials that were on Outlook. And then I can just start writing my notes here. So I have everyone who was in the meeting. I can make my notes here and keep everything tracked. Now I can share this page on SkyDrive or whatever. We'll show you that in just a moment. But kind of the old-fashioned way, if you wanted to print these out or share them, you hit the File menu and go to Send. And then you can send this many different ways. You can send it as an attachment for people who have OneNote. You can send it as a PDF or even a Word document. You can send it to Word. Or just email the page here. So if I click email, it just automatically populates the people who are in the meetings in the to line. I can add anything else I want to. And you can share the meetings out that way in Outlook. And that's all put together. And again, if you get the new version of Office, that comes with Outlook and OneNote already there. So you'd have both of them. So that's just one of the ways to share with OneNote. But let's talk about some other ones, including projects. So how to share your OneNote notebooks. Let me go down to this notebook here I have called the Dave and Doug Project. And I'll show you here of how you can share that. Let me click File. And you can see here all the URLs where all these notebooks are. Some are on SkyDrive, some are on my other thing. And let's see here. And we'll do the Dave and Doug thing for the project and share on web. So this is how I would share something with Dave. And let me just show you how I would send an invite here. And then I'll actually bring Dave in to talk about it. If you would come in and just get set up, that'd be cool. So if I go to share on web or network here, I can take this, you can see it's on my C drive. I click this share and I can send it to several different areas. I could send it to my SkyDrive. I'm connected to my SharePoint at Microsoft. I'm connected to a test site and I can add other places. So that's how I would move things around on move notebooks. Because again, if you have an older version of OneNote, you may have most of them on the drive. Now, sharing and security is one thing we always want to talk about. So let me look at, another notebook that I sent to Dave called The Big Project. And this is how I shared it with Dave. I went to File, Share, and there's several different ways you can share it once it's on SkyDrive. And again, I put it on SkyDrive and right now only I have the permissions. And then I sent Dave, hello Dave.
Hello.
Say hi to Dave, everyone. Thank you. I sent Dave an invite. And you can do it right here in the send an email. And you notice here on the right-hand side, I have a pull-down. I can give them edit permissions or I can just give people view permissions. And then you can see who has permissions down here. And there's several areas in SkyDrive or OneNote where you can see if it's shared or not. And so if I wanted to cut Dave off, I could remove the user or just change his permissions. I'm not going to do that because then this demo wouldn't work.
It would be kind of rude, too.
It would be kind of rude to do it right in front of you. That's the problem with sharing with someone who's right next to you. We'll pretend you're someplace else, like Pittsburgh or something like that. The other way you can send is get a sharing link. And here, this way, if you're on Skype or on IM, you can just send them the link this way. So, again, you can get a view link or an edit link. I'll create that link. And I could send this to all of you right now. We could all share the notebook. I'm not going to do that, though. I'm going to let this page refresh that just shows you. Again, now it's shared with Doug and Dave, and now this has this link. And as soon as I don't want, though, I can hit the disabled link, and now that link won't work. So again, that's the permission level that you can work with on dealing with sharing notebooks. And you're going to choose how you share Okay, so I sent you a link, and you tell us what we're going to do here.
Yeah, so Doug sent me a link, and I'm going to outlook.com. I'll just do that now.
I'm going to follow along on mine for people who can see what we're doing here.
So I go to outlook.com, and I see his email there. It says, Doug Thomas has shared a notebook with you. And then I'm going to click that, in this case, touch that email to open it. And it says, great, here's the OneNote you can edit. So it says the big project. I click that link. And, you know, OneNote, I do have OneNote on this computer, but OneNote doesn't assume that. So you could have any kind of tablet, any kind of phone, or, you know, virtually any kind of device, and it opens the notebook in the OneNote web app. It actually does this really cool fade-in thing, too, when it opens. It's pretty amazing. So anyway, here I am in the OneNote web app, and by default, I'm just here, and I can, you know, read this. It's sort of in read-only mode, but if I want to edit it, I go to Edit Notebook in the top left, and then I click or touch Edit in the OneNote web app. And boom, the cursor is right there, right at the top, ready, flashing and ready for me to start editing. So I'm going to go through here. Doug's sort of a sloppy typer. he needs some refinement. So that's what I'm here to do. I'm here to edit for him.
Okay.
So here I am, and I'm going to go over here, and I'm going to say, actually, no, it wasn't 35 years. We've been around for even longer, so I'm going to change that to 40 years of coolness. And coolness is a little, I don't know, a little too casual. I'm going to say 40 years of innovation. There we go. And the cool thing about the web app is that it saves automatically. In fact, one of the things I wanted to show you is, you know, if you close the browser window, it does two things. The first thing it does is close the browser window, of course, but then it also saves your stuff right away. In fact, it might have saved it even before you closed it. But anyway, I'll show you. If I close this browser window, then you'll see that when I go back and open up the big project, my edits will be there. So it's a pretty forgiving web app, that OneNote web app.
That OneNote web app.
Yeah.
And so I'm just going to wait and see if it updates here. And again, this is going to update. So I have the web app open here so you can see what Dave was kind of working on. And then it's also going to change here. In fact, look, it's already changed here on my OneNote. We'll go back to the web app in a second. So now I'm in OneNote. And as you can see, not only has it changed, it's done a couple things here. It has the initials of the person that changed them, DL, Dave Ludwig, is there, and it's been greened out. So you also changed this other thing over here on the important dates. So that shows you in real time how it's changing, but also if you've gone back to the page. Now, if you notice here on the left-hand side of my notebooks, we have other things that are bold. That means it's things I haven't looked at yet. So that's one of the great things about OneNote is you can turn this stuff off. In fact, I'm going to go up to here to the history tab. I can turn off, I can hide the author so I don't have to see those things. See how I turn them on and off here?
And you can mark as red.
And you can mark them also different colors?
You can mark as red.
Oh, you can mark as red. That's the other thing over here. So over here, you can turn that on and off and say, okay, I can turn off that feature if I don't want to have these things bold when it is. So that way you'll know when something's new. And let's go back to the web app.
And that was pretty fast.
That was pretty fast.
That was sync.
Okay, so let's go back to the web app and see if it's there, and then we'll have to. And there it is on the web app. So I can also do the same thing on the web app. I click View, Show Authors, and there the authors are listed there. So if I wanted to yell at someone for changing my beautiful headline, I know exactly who to do that with. Okay, cool. So we can do more on sharing in the Q&A section, but I'm just going to have to go back here to finish up the webinar here. So we'll have links to a lot of the stuff here, including this page, which is all the different ways that you can get OneNote on your devices, Windows Phone, iPhone, iPad. We'll have link Android. All of those will have links to that. And you can find those links on this page right here, aka.ms/LN123. ON OneNote. You can find links there. We'll have the video up later this week, early next week. Also, anything about the Office webinar series in general, you can go to aka.ms/offweb. Later today, we're going to announce something that you right now are going to learn. If you're on Windows 8 or have a Windows Phone 8, you can now get an Office 15-minute webinar app that you can play. So if you want to play along, You can watch the recording and then work on the work on your computer as we go through one of the things that we've worked on in the Office webinar, or you can, on Windows 8, you could park it on the left side of your screen and listen as you type and work on the things that we've talked about in the Office webinar. So you can search that, and Marketplace will have the links up later today on our main page. That's it for this week. Next week, we're going to talk about more about the Office web apps and sharing stuff. Maybe we'll have Dave back to share Excel, or we'll collaborate or something like that. But for now, thank you for joining this Office 15-minute webinar.